Ladies and gentlemen, with Snapshot 22W14A, we got changes to Predicates, new advancement triggers, and some news for custom world formats. My name is slicedlime, and in this video I'll be guiding you through all the technical changes. If you're looking for the gameplay changes, check out the video linked right here for all of those. Anyway, let's dive in with some entity data changes. Cats no longer have a cat type field with an index, instead they now have a variant field with a namespaced ID. A similar change has been made to frogs. They also now have a variant field with a lowercase v, which stores frog variants as namespace IDs. There's also a new field in player data, last death location, which contains a dimension string and a list of three integers representing the block position of the player's last death, called POS. Let's get into those predicate changes. Predicates for entity subtypes, that is player, fishing hook, lightning bolt, and cat type, have been replaced with a single predicate called type specific. The type specific predicate has a type field, which is one of player, fishing hook, lightning, or cat, corresponding to the old removed types, and with the same fields as those sub predicates used to have. Cat type now also uses that new cat variant field to match instead of the texture name. In addition to this, there are two new type specific types. One is for frogs, which works exactly like the cat sub-predicate in letting you match the variant of the frog. The other one is slime, which applies for slimes and magma cubes and has a single field matching size. The smallest slime type is size 1. Those new sub-predicate types are used for loot tables, where the special case size-dependent loot drops of slimes and magma cubes are now data-driven and part of their loot tables. Frogs now also actually kill their food instead of dropping hard-coded item types, which means that the loot drops for frog food are now part of the food's death loot. The attack used by frogs to kill food has base attack strength of 10. Let's move on to a couple of new advancement triggers. The first one is called Item Delivered to Player. This is triggered when an LA delivers an item to a player and has a single condition for the player. Our second new trigger is called LA Drop Item on Block, which is triggered when an LA drops an item on a block. There are three conditions for this one: player, for the player who gave the item to the LA, location, for the location of the block the item is dropped on, and item, for the item that was dropped. Another change to advancements is that the location field has been removed from the triggers location, slept in bed, hero of the village, and voluntary exile, since the player.location field does exactly the same thing. Let's move on to some tag news. A block tag has been removed. Ancient City Center replaceable. Its contents is now inlined into Ancient City replaceable instead. There are three new block tags in this version: Dead Bush May Place On, Mangrove Logs Can Grow Through, and Mangrove Roots Can Grow Through. There are cat variant tags in this version too: Default Spawns and Full Moon Spawns. They control which types of cats can spawn by default and during full moon nights, which is actually different. There's a new entity type tag called Frog Food, controlling which entity types frogs will attempt to eat. A game event tag has been renamed. Warden Events Can Listen is now called Warden Can Listen. A similar one has also been added, Shrieker Can Listen. And a new item tag has been added called Compasses, containing Compass and Recovery Compass by default. Before we move on to more technical news, let me ask you to point your compass at the like button for the video. For every like on the video, YouTube is more likely to recommend it to others, so I appreciate your help. Thank you. In resource pack news, a single noteworthy thing: Warden UV mapping has changed to fix a bug. If you've already made custom warden textures, you'll need to update to match the new mapping. In news for custom worlds, a number of changes have been made for features. Disk and ice patch features now have a new parameter called can origin replace, which is a tag specifying a required block at the origin. This is set to previously hardcoded values for water for all the existing vanilla disks and snow block for all vanilla ice patches. There's a new feature type too, called Surface Disk, with the same parameters as the previously existing disk types. The Glow Lichen feature has been renamed to Multi-Phase Growth. The rest of the feature changes are all related to trees. There's a new optional field in tree features called Root Placer. This contains a new type of placer for roots, which currently only has one possible type: Mangrove Root Placer. These have a number of fields: Root Provider, with a block state provider for the roots placed; Can Grow Through, which is a tag specifying blocks the roots can grow through; Muddy Roots In, specifying a tag of blocks where an alternate provider is used, which is specified as Muddy Roots Provider. It also has a Y offset in provider, determining how high up the main trunk of the tree should start, and the max root length and max root width, determining the max length and width of the roots. Finally, there's a random skew chance, which is a float chance between 0 and 1. There's also a new trunk placer type called upwards branching trunk placer. This also has a can grow through tag field, as well as a place branch per log probability float between 0 and 1, and extra branch length and extra branch steps int providers, where extra branch steps has to be positive, and extra branch length has to be non-negative. There's also a new tree decorator type called attached to leaves, placing decorations around leaves. It has a probability float field between 0 and 1 for the probability of placing a decoration connected to each leaf, exclusion radius XZ and exclusion radius Y, controlling how far apart decorations must be at a minimum. It has a block provider for the decoration to place, a directions list that contains at least one direction for the offset from the leaves to place the decoration, and a required empty blocks int value between 1 and 16. In addition to that, a probability field has been added to the leaves vine decorator, which was previously hard-coded as 0.25. Finally, let's go through a couple of changes to structures. The block rot structure processor field rotable blocks now works like other tag fields and is prefaced with a hash when referring to named tags. And the value field that wrapped all configurations of all structures in the previous snapshot is now gone once again. That's all for this time. Thank you for staying with me to the end of the video, I really appreciate it. If you want to know more about technical changes for the wild update, check out this video with details from an earlier snapshot.